Hello, hello. It is Gabe again from Frame. We are on part 4, I believe, of our tutorial series. Yes, indeed. So in the last video, we looked at a few really fun things. A quick recap, we brought some streaming screens right onto the wall so that people can share their screen or share their webcam. Again, I'm making kind of an office for the Frame team throughout this whole series. I've also added the Frame logo over here. We've learned about snapping assets to the walls. We've brought a web screenshot onto this wall. This is an asset that lets you kind of take a screenshot of a website and display it here. This way everyone on the team can see the latest version of the Frame website, learn.framevr.io. You can't fully interact with it. It's just the latest image of the website. But in this episode of the tutorial series, we're going to dive into adding some other kind of web elements into the page, specifically using links. So let's dive in. What I want to do is I want to make it easy for my team to see our blog. And the way I'm going to do this is pretty straightforward. First I got to make a button that they can click to see the blog. So the way I'm going to do that, I'm going to add a text asset into the Frame. So here we go, text. Boom, just shows up like a text label. The text asset is really good for kind of simple one-liners, like little labels, little simple bits of text. Now I'm gonna turn on edit mode. You can either click the button or use the U hotkey. Here I am pressing U. And I'm gonna click on the text label. Now the edit menu shows up in the bottom left with lots of different things that you can do. Text even has a fun spin that'll give it a nice spin. You can pick how you want it to spin. I don't want to do that for this though, so I'm going to turn that right off. What I want to do is call this Frame Blog. And I'm going to click Update Text. There it is. I like the colors, but you can change the colors if you want. And then I'm going to add a link to it. Now, when you click Add a Link, you've got a few options. And these are pretty cool. You can actually have it link to another frame entirely so that when people click it, it takes them into another frame, which is super powerful. We're going to get into that more later. Or you can add a notification link. When people click it, it can send you a text message or send you an email. You can link to Spot, which will send them to another place in the frame. There's a whole lot, but the one I want to focus on right here is web link. Now, I want it so that when people click on this, it takes them to the Frame blog. learn.framevr.io/blog. But I don't want it to open in a new tab. I'd like them to somehow stay on the frame while they view it. So I'm gonna change the type. Instead of new tab, I'm gonna make it embed. Now embed only works, if your link is able to be embedded in an iframe. And most sites, that works just fine, but there are some where it doesn't. For ours, it does. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn it to embed. I'm gonna click set web link. Now that's set and that's wonderful, but I also want to make sure it's in the right place. Right now it's kind of floating in the air, which you can tell as soon as you move around. I'm just moving around with the A key. I use WASD to move around. So I'm going to go ahead and do what we learned before, which is snap to surface. Boom. Snap it right to the wall. Move it right over. It's in a good place, so I'm going to lock it there. And now take a look at what happens when I'm going to turn off edit mode. Take a look at what happens when people click it. So it says, would you like to open it? Open, boom. And this way, my team could check out our blog anytime they want just by clicking on this, and they see it right here. They don't need to leave the frame. They get it in this overlay down in the bottom left, and they can fully interact with it as well. So they can actually click on buttons. It's an iframe, so you can do it all. If they want to minimize it, you can. If you want to make it big, you can. And if you want to close it out, you can. Okay, so that's great, but I'd like to actually add another one. This is one that will open into another in another tab entirely. So for this one, I'm gonna do add a link, and we're gonna say web link. And this one, I'd like to open to our YouTube channel. So what I'm gonna do is put the link there, and that is gonna be new tab. I'm gonna do set web link. And of course, I need to update the text to say YouTube channel. And update text. There we have it. I'm gonna snap to surface. Boom, it's a little bit of overlap there, so we're gonna move it right up. Boom. And now, when people click on this, same deal, but this will actually open in a new tab. Okay. Wow, it's already been about 5 minutes. I don't want to make any of these really more than 5 minutes, but so far we've learned about some links and some of the really powerful things you can do with them. We've looked at embed links that open up down at the bottom left. We've looked at links that open up in a new tab entirely. We've looked at the text asset, which is really cool. And I think that'll be about it for this video. Next time we will dive into more fun things. I'll see you then.